Hello everyone, this is Gargi Shekhar, Assistant Professor in the Department of Agriculture at Maya Group of Colleges. The subject of Elementary Agriculture Engineering is very interesting, and in today's session we'll be discussing about the tractor engines. Now you might have seen these type of engines very frequently in the farms. We'll be discussing all type of engines today. So talking about the different types of engines, first of all you must know that what is a heat engine. A heat engine is a machine for converting heat developed by the burning fuel to the useful work. It can be said that the engine is equipped with equipment which generates thermal energy and transforms it to the mechanical energy. Now you can observe in this figure that this is a typical type of generator, which we call it in normal language, and it is a type of heat engine. These type of engines are very common at the farms. Now we should know that what are the different classifications of heat engines. Basically, heat engines are classified into three types based on the combustion of fuel. First of all, on the basis of combustion of fuel, there are two types of engine: external combustion engine and internal combustion engine. Then the second category is based on the fuel used. Basically, we use diesel engine or we use petrol engine. Or the third type of engine, which is based on the fuel, is the gas engine. Then comes the engines based on the ignition of the fuel. Basically, on this basis, there is a spark ignition engine that is also called as carburetor type engine, and the compression ignition engine that is termed to be injector type engines. Now, if we talk about the external combustion engine, these engines were very large in size and the working medium was steam. It is generated in the boiler located outside the engine and allowed to the cylinder to operate the piston to do the mechanical work. You can observe in this figure, this is a train that was running on the steam. We can see there is a crankshaft, the piston is there, steam is coming from boiling the water by the combustion of the coal. Coal is the fuel used here, and the steam is generated and that is used to run the trains. Similarly, the Newcomen atmospheric engines were used as external combustion engine. Then comes the internal combustion engine. This is the most common type of engines used nowadays in the automobiles. The internal combustion engine, the combustion of the fuel takes place inside the engine cylinder and heat is generated within the cylinder. This heat is added to the air inside the cylinder and thus the pressure of the air is increased tremendously. This high pressure air moves the piston which rotates the crankshaft and thus mechanical work is done. So you can observe in this figure, this is the crankshaft which is connected with the piston with the connecting rod, and it is connected to the camshaft which is helping the valve times, and thus the fuel is ignited. Now coming to the next type, you must know how the engine works. You can observe in this figure, as earlier also I said, this is the movement of crankshaft. This is moving the piston to and fro in the reciprocating movement, and that is helping the valves to move and use this energy. Now during this energy of reciprocation, there are four types of combustions taking place. The first is the intake. The intake involves the taking up of the fuel to the combustion chamber. Then comes the compression. Then is combustion. And finally, there is an exhaust. Combustion is also termed to be the power stroke. So basically, there are four types of strokes which is taking place inside an internal combustion engine. These four strokes are taking place in two revolutions in case of four stroke engines and in one revolution in case of two stroke engine. Now this is a diesel engine, and diesel is used here as a fuel. Now we talk about the petrol engine, where petrol is used as a fuel. Basically, petrol engines are used in the automobiles or vehicles like cars, or in scooters or scooties, motorcycles, etc. Here a spark plug is present. in the case of diesel engine, we don't have spark plugs. Now you can observe here the piston is moving from BDC to TDC. The one stroke is termed to be the movement of piston from BDC to TDC. So BDC is termed to be the bottom dead center and TDC is termed to be the top dead center. Now we come to the next, that is the construction of an IC engine. So you can observe here in the main parts of an engine is, if we come from this side, there is a water jacket, there are exhaust valves, spark plugs, cylinder, piston, cool inlet valve, coil inlet valve, carburetor, throttle valve, valve springs, camshaft, jet, float chamber, water pump, dynamo, gear driving camshaft, oil pump, crankshaft, flywheel, toothed ring, starter motor, connecting rod, piston rings, exhaust pipe, and again the water jacket. So this is these are the main parts of the engine. While talking about the IC engine converts the reciprocating motion of the piston to the rotary motion. The piston which reciprocates in the cylinder is very close to the fit in the cylinder. So you can observe that these are the main parts of the engine. Now we talk about the construction of the IC engine, that is the internal combustion engine in case of diesel, when diesel is used as the fuel. The rings are inserted in the circumferential grooves of the piston to prevent the leakage of the gases from the side of the piston. So you can observe here there is a rocker arm, this valve spring, valve sparkling plug, then piston, water jacket, gungeon pin, cylinder, connecting rod, weight balance, then crankshaft, camshaft, chain driven from the crankshaft, tappet, and the push rod. So these are the mechanisms which is used for the construction of an IC engine on the whole. Now we come to the construction of the IC engine. Usually the cylinder is bored in the cylinder block and a gasket made up of copper sheet or asbestos is inserted between the cylinder, which is also termed as cylinder liner, and the cylinder head is to avoid the leakage. There you can observe there is an inlet valve, a spark plug, exhaust valve. One stroke is termed to be the TDC and the movement of piston from BDC to TDC. The combustion chamber, piston, connecting rod, cylinder flange, top center, crankshaft and bottom center. Now, you should understand that the combustion space is provided at the top of the cylinder head where combustion takes place. Now we come to the next one, that is construction of the IC engine in which the piston and connecting rod is there. Now look, you can observe here this is the cross section of the piston. There is a crown, the head of the piston is termed to be the crown. Then comes the top ring and bottom ring. The skirt is there. There is a gungeon pin which connects the piston to the connecting rod. Then the connecting rod has two ends, one is the little end and other is the big end. The little end is connected to the gungeon pin and it connects the piston to the connecting rod, and the big end is connected to the crank pin which is connected to the crankshaft. So basically the piston moves when the crankshaft moves. So you can observe the end of the connecting rod connecting the piston is called as the small end. The pin called gungeon pin or the wrist pin is provided for connecting the piston and the connecting rod at the small end. The other end of the connecting rod connecting the crankshaft is called big end. When the piston is moved up and down, the motion is transmitted to the crankshaft by connecting rod and the crankshaft makes rotary motion. Now we will be talking about the different crankshaft movements. The crankshaft rotates in main bearing which are fitted in the crankcase. The flywheel is provided at one end of the crankshaft for smoothing the uneven torque produced by the engine. There is an oil sump at the bottom of the engine which contains the lubricating oil for lubricating the different parts of engine. So you can observe here, this is the flywheel. This is termed to be the flywheel, and there are certain sprockets made up over here. This is the crankshaft. There is an oil passage over here. These are the connecting rods, which is connecting the piston to the crankshaft. These are the main general bearings, which is connecting the crankshaft to the camshaft. Now, this is termed to be the nose crankshaft nose, and this is the general crankshaft crank pin bearing. So, these are the basic parts of the crankshaft. Now we come to the next one, that is, how is the combustion taking place, or what are the working principles of the IC engine? So if we talk about the working principles, first of all, you should understand that a mixture of fuel with correct amount of air is exploded in the engine cylinder, which is closed at one end. As a result of this explosion, heat is released, and this heat causes the pressure of burning gases to increase. This pressure forces a close fitting piston to move and move down the cylinder. The movement of the piston is transmitted to the crankshaft by connecting rods, so that the crankshaft rotates and turns a flywheel connected to it. So you can see here, what is happening over here is, this part is having oil all over. This is the movement of crankshaft. It rotates in a 360 degree manner. So when it is rotating, it is actually moving the piston in to and fro manner. And when it is moving it in to and fro manner, the oil sump is having the oil which is coming to the piston, and that is carried over above. There is high compression taking place, so the fuel converts into gaseous form, and this gaseous form is having a lot of compression, and this compression gives a power stroke. These burning gases are heated up with the help of spark ignitions, and then there is heat released. Or you can observe in the power stroke, in case there is no spark plug present, there are fuel injectors which injects the droplets of fuel air fuel mixtures, and that is giving it the combustion. So in this way, the power is generated. And that is the working principle of the IC engine. The power is taken from the rotating crankshaft to do the mechanical work. To obtain the continuous rotation of the crankshaft, the explosion has to be repeated continuously. That is, before the explosion to take place, the used gases are expelled from the cylinder, fresh charge of fuel and air is admitted to the cylinder, and the piston moved back to its starting position. The sequences of the events taking place in an engine is called the working cycle of the engine, and the sequence of the events taking place inside the engine are as follows. You can observe over here. I'll again show it to you. Look, from here the air sump, oil sump is there. The charge, that is the air fuel mixtures, move over this place. The piston is carrying the fuel from here, and it moves upwards from the BDC to the TDC. At this place, there is compression taking place, and due to high compression, there is ignition. And when there is ignition, there is the power stroke taking place. During the power stroke, the gases which are not necessary to be here is given out through the exhaust. So there are four strokes taking place over here. The first is the suction, then comes compression, then comes power, and lastly the exhaust. During the exhaust phase, the piston again drives over here to the BDC. So this is the main working principle of the IC engine. You can observe over here the four strokes, as I already explained. The four stroke engines, in the four stroke engines, the four events mainly, namely suction, compression, power and exhaust, takes place inside the cylinder, and the four events are completed in four strokes of the piston, that is two revolutions of the crankshaft. So I'll again show you here. This is the cylinder 1, where intake is taking place, that is the fuel is taken to the combustion chamber. Now, during this phase, the fuel is compressed at very high pressure, and at this high pressure, there is an ignition of power over here. So this is the power stroke, and then comes the exhaust valve that is giving out the air mixture that is not important or which is now a wastage for this part of engine. Then again the suction takes place. So this is the four cycles or four events which is taking place, and these are termed to be the four strokes of the piston. Okay, now we'll move further in the next slide, that is the four stroke engine of diesel and petrol. Now you can observe here, and this engine has valves for controlling the inlet of the charge and the outlet of the exhaust. The opening and closing of the valve is controlled by the cams fitted on the camshaft. The camshaft is driven by the crankshaft with the help of suitable gears or chains, and the camshaft runs at the half speed of the crankshaft. Now this is a very important point. The crankshaft has a double speed from the camshaft. Now you can observe over here, I'll again explain it. This is the crankshaft. The crankshaft moves over here in this direction. The connecting rod is having the piston, and the piston rings carries the fuel over here in the combustion chamber. The air fuel mixture, that is the charge, is given by the intake valve that is open. Now in case of petrol engine, there is a spark plug present over here. As soon as the compression is taking place, the air fuel mixture is compressed and the spark plugs gives a firing. Now as soon as it gives the firing, there are exhaust gases which goes out. Now this all takes place in a fraction of seconds. So there is a timing of all the valves to open and close in this area. Now we come to the next part, that is the two-stroke engines. The two-stroke engines or the petrol engines, basically two-stroke engines are always petrol engines. In the two-stroke engines, the whole sequence of events, that is suction, compression, power and exhaust, are completed in two strokes of the piston, that is in one revolution of crankshaft. In case of four-stroke engines, there are two revolutions of the crankshaft and the strokes are four. Here all the four strokes are completed in one revolution of the crankshaft. Now there are no valves in this type of engines. These engines are very common in the two-wheelers like motorcycles or in scooters or scooties. Now if you observe, the gas movement takes place through the holes called ports. So here there are ports present. You can observe here there are two strokes, that is upstroke and downstroke. So during the upstroke, what we observe is the crankshaft is moving, the valves are opening over here, the air fuel mixture goes inside and it transfers the port to here. Here the ignition is taking place and the fuel is compressed over here. After the burning of the fuel, the forces of piston down compressing the fuel cranks in the crankcase comes up. So here the movement, you can see it is coming now to the next half. The first half is having the ignition and compression, and the second half is having the power stroke and exhaust. So all these four strokes are completed in one revolution of the crankshaft. The crankcase of the engine is airtight, in which the crankshaft rotates. So you can observe, this is the two stroke petrol engine. Now you should know the upward stroke of the piston. As I already said, it is having the suction and compression strokes. So the first stroke in the two stroke engine has the upward stroke of piston that includes the suction and compression. When the piston moves upwards, it covers two of the ports. This traps the charge of air fuel mixture drawn already to the cylinder, and the piston compresses the charge and also uncovers the suction port. Now fresh mixture is drawn through this port to the crankcase, and just before the end of the stroke, the mixture of the cylinder is ignited. So you can observe what's happening over here. In the beginning of the stroke, there is suction, that is the inlet port is open and the petrol air mixture goes inside, and there is compression taking place over here. Now after compression, simultaneously the exhaust gases will move out and the spark ignition will take place, and here will be the power stroke generating, the exhaust gases will move out, and this will be during the first stroke. Fine. Now we come to the next, that is just during this stroke, both suction and compression events are completed. Now all these happens in the fraction of seconds, so you must know that all these are coming in one revolution of the crankshaft only. The burning of the fuel rises the temperature and the pressure of the gases. When the piston moves downwards, it closes the suction port, and further the piston uncovers the first exhaust port and then transfer port. The fresh charge in the crankcase moves to the cylinder through the transfer port during the downward stroke of the piston power and exhaust events are completed. So that is all about the two-stroke engines. So you can observe over here, there is a fuel tank, spark plug, water jacket, telltale, and exhaust port, cylinder, air filter, fuel cock, water separator, transfer port, carburetor, piston, connecting rod, crankshaft, breaker, and water pump over here. So this is the working cycle, power, exhaust, induction, compression, power and exhaust. This is the work cycle of the two-stroke petrol engine. Now we'll be comparing the two-stroke engine and four-stroke engine. In case of four-stroke engine, one power stroke for every two revolutions of the crankshaft is present, while in case of two-stroke engine, one power stroke for each revolution of crankshaft is present. In case of four-stroke engine, there are inlet and exhaust valve in the engine, whereas in two-stroke engine, there are inlet and exhaust ports instead of valves. The crankcase is not fully closed and airtight in case of four-stroke engines, but the crankcase is fully closed and airtight in case of two-stroke engine. The top of the piston compresses the charge in case of four-stroke engine. Both sides of piston compress the charge in case of two-stroke engines. The size of the flywheel is comparatively larger in four-stroke engines, whereas the size of the flywheel is comparatively smaller in the two-stroke engines. The fuel is fully consumed in the four-stroke engine, whereas the fuel is not fully consumed in case of two-stroke engine. Then the weight of the engine per HP is very high in case of four-stroke engine, whereas the weight of the engine per HP is comparatively low in case of two-stroke engine. The thermal efficiency is high in case of two-stroke engine, whereas the thermal efficiency is comparatively very low in case of two-stroke engine. The removal of exhaust gases are very easy in four-stroke engines, whereas it is comparatively difficult in case of two-stroke engines. The torque produced is even in four-stroke engines, whereas the torque produces is less even in two-stroke engine. For a given weight, engine would give only half of the power of the two-stroke engines, whereas for the same weight, two-stroke engine gives twice the power that of the four-stroke engines. All type of speed are possible, high to low, in four-stroke engines, but mostly high speed engines are there in two-stroke engines. It can be operated in one direction only. That is a limitation for the four-stroke engines, whereas a two-stroke engine can be operated in both directions, clockwise and counterclockwise. So that is all about the engines. So we'll be talking about the special features of the diesel engines. The first says engine has high compression ratios ranging from 14:1 to 22:1. During the compression stroke, the engine attains high pressure ranging from 30 to 45 kg per centimeter square and high temperature about 500 centigrade. At the end of the compression stroke, fuel is injected into the cylinder through injectors or atomizers at the very high pressure ranging from 120 to 200 kg per centimeter square. The ignition takes place due to high heat of the compression only. There is no external spark plug in the diesel engines. Diesel engine has better slogging and lugging ability, that is, it maintains higher torque for the longer duration of time at lower speeds. So that is all about the diesel engine specifications. Now we'll be comparing the diesel engine with petrol engine. So in case of diesel engine, there is no carburetor required, ignition coil or spark plug required, whereas in case of petrol engine, carburetor, engine coil and spark plug is required. The compression ratio for diesel engine is 14:1 and 22:1, whereas the compression ratios for petrol engine is 5:1 to 8:1. In the diesel engine, diesel oil is used as the fuel, and in petrol engine, petrol or gasoline or power kerosene can be used as the fuel. In diesel engine, only air is sucked in the cylinder in suction stroke, whereas in petrol engine, the mixture of fuel and air is sucked in the cylinder in the suction stroke. It has got a fuel injection pump and injector in case of diesel engine, whereas in case of petrol engine, it has got no fuel injection pump or injector. Instead, it is having a carburetor and ignition coil. In case of diesel engine, fuel is injected in combustion chamber where burning fuel takes place due to heat of the compression, whereas in case of petrol engine, the air fuel mixture is compressed in combustion chamber where it is ignited by the spark plug. The thermal efficiency varies from 32% to 38% in case of diesel engine, whereas petrol engine has thermal efficiency of 25% to 32%. The engine weight per horsepower is very high in case of diesel engine, whereas it is comparatively low in case of petrol engine. The operating cost is low in diesel engine, whereas it is very high in petrol engine. The compression pressure inside the cylinder varies in case of diesel engine, whereas in petrol engine, the compression pressure varies from 6 to 10. In case of the diesel engine and petrol engine, it is best to use diesel engine in the tractors as it has high efficiencies and it is maintained at low cost. So that is all about the engines. We'll be discussing many more upcoming topics of farm machinery in the coming lectures or sessions. Thank you. Have a nice day.